Okay, we got here an Arcticat Panther 660 touring snowmobile, and the guy's having problems with it overheating, so he wanted me to change the thermostat on it, and so I'm going to do a little bit of a video on a thermostat change. The thermostats are in at the parts store today. I'm actually, I had them order a couple of different thermostats that measure up specification wise, size and temperature. And I'm going to take the old one out and take it up there, and we're going to match it up and see which one we need to get. And those are $7 thermostats. The one that this calls for is a $56 thermostat, so quite a difference there. Almost $50 difference in price. So anyways, thought I'd just do a little video on this here. So I'll get the hood up on it and probably have to use the tripod, and we'll see what we got. All right, right here's the thermostat housing, and I'm not sure if I need to drain this or not. I'm gonna take and see what we got here for. And I'll need my flashlight. Okay, and you probably can't see, but it's in there. It's up to the about even with the top of that hose right there. And so I probably will have to drain that down and see if I can show you where the drain is on these. See this little hose here with a white cap on it right there? That's the coolant drain. So I'm gonna see if I can figure a way to drain that into something. I think I can actually move it back here and set a can right down in there or something, or a jug or something. So all I gotta do is take it down enough to get it out of the thermostat area. Okay, I got her drained down a little bit. Now I'm going to pull a few things apart here. Gonna take off this little zip tie that holds all these bundles together, and unplug this temperature sensor. Get that out of the way. I got two hose clamps. And actually three, I'm going to take this hose clear off. Okay, this is 12. Two of them are just nuts on studs, and the third one is a bolt. And actually I see another hose clamp to take off. This bottom one here is a bolt. Okay. And right there's the thermostat actually. So I think I'll just leave that together like it is. And pull this thermostat out of here. And somebody's punched this thermostat out. As you can see, it's not much of a thermostat anymore. Somebody punched it out. So I'll take that with me. I'm gonna take that up here with me, and I want this housing to go up with me. So I'm going to see if I can get this belt guard out of the way. And one more club hose clamp right here. And take that clear off. And this other hose off of here. Yeah, see that one there wants to be a little tougher. Cool. I do, so I don't ruin the hose, and I take and put a piece of rubber on there, take it, put your pliers, take it right off of there. Okay. And so that part's going with me, the thermostat and this other housing. And it looks like this gasket's still good here. And I've got all kinds of depth here. I'm going to go ahead and measure that just to be sure. And we can go in a good, I'm gonna say an inch. Got a full inch there. And so now what I do is I'll take that up with me to the parts store and we'll make sure we get the right one. Okay. Now we're ready to put the new thermostat on. And what I got is, got everything all wrapped up here, but kind of basically an $8 thermostat. Seems to fit just fine. Everything looks good, so we'll put her on there. And of course, reassembly is just the opposite of disassembly, so I won't bore you with all the having to watch me do that part. Okay, there's one little modification I'm going to do to this thermostat. Is I'm going to drill a small, tiny little hole right here at the top, or what I'm going to make is the top. That's so that you can have a small amount of flow before the thermostat opens. And the reason I'm doing that is because they actually had pretty much the same thing already on here. Theirs was a little bit bigger, but then they had this little like a check valve type thing in there. So I don't know why that has to be there. But just to be on the safe side, I'm going to go ahead and put that little hole on this thermostat here, and then we'll put her on there. Okay, everything's back together like it's supposed to be. I got the zip tie back on. Got the drain valve shut back off, and that's zip tied back to the front hose. And I'm going to put some coolant back into the jug. I'll use whatever come out of there. It's like maybe a quart, something like that, I got out of there. So that, and then I'll top it off on this side, and then if I need to, I've got some more coolant to add to it. And I got to put the belt guard back on, which I'm gonna have to take the front pin off to do. And other than that, we're gonna take her and give her a try out and see what she does. Okay, to finalize everything out, before I put the cap on, I watched the level go down and kept topping it off, let it go down, top it off, let it go down. And until I got everything back in that I'd taken out. And what we got her is we got her suspended up on the hoist just enough so the track can turn freely, so I don't have to worry about this thing shooting over the front of the trailer. And so far she's been running out for about 10 minutes or so, and I've revved her up quite a bit. We got her up to, it's definitely up to heat temperature. And so far we don't have a temp light on or anything, so I think we got her doing pretty good. So I'm going to let her run probably another 10 minutes or so, and I'll shut her down and let the guy know she's all set to go and he can do the final test on it. Should be getting some snow here in a couple of days, so if we get some snow, maybe he'll take her out and run her and see what it does. Well, thanks for watching.